morning everyone, this is Rohit Khurana. How are you all? I hope you all are fine and studying at home properly. So in the last session of grade 8, we have started chapter number 2 of exponents. In that session we have done some rules that what are exponents and what are its rules. But in this session we'll solve some of the problems. Last time I have given you to solve 1 to 4 questions of exercise 2.1, and now we are starting our 5th question. You can see some problems are here. Before solving those problems, we'll have a recap of the rules of exponents. The first rule was x raised to power m and x raised to power n will become x raised to power m plus n. When base is same and the exponents are different and the operation of multiplication is given in between them, then the powers will be added. So x raised to power m plus n. It's opposite. Base is same but the sign is of division in between them, then the powers will be minus x raised to power m minus n. See, one third rule, x raised to power m whole power n will become x raised to power m into n. Fourth rule is x power m into y power m. Base is different but the power, but the exponents are same. So x into y whole power m. Last is second last, x power m divided by y power m. Sign of division is there, so it will be divided x upon y whole power m. Any rational number whose power is 0, that will become 1. And the last rule is, if the power is given with a negative sign, x raised to power minus m will become 1 upon x power m. So these were rules you should keep in your mind. Here, first problem is, find the value of m. So 2 raised to power m upon 2 raised to power minus 2 will be equal to 2 raised to power 3. We need to find the value of this m here. So we know very well, this 1 upon 2 power minus 2, when will it come upside, this negative 2, this minus 2 will become plus 2. 2 power m into 2 power plus 2 will come upside is equal to 2 power 3. Now we'll see the rule number first, x raised to power m into x raised to power n. Base is same, powers are different. Base is same here also, but the powers are different, m and 2. What was the rule? Powers will be added. So we are adding the power here. 2, 2, base is same, power will be m plus 2 will be equal to 2 raised to power 3. Here on the both sides of equal, this is the equal sign. The base is same, okay, then we can compare the exponents. Means base is same, compare the exponents. And comparing exponents, m plus 2 will be equal to 3. M plus 2 will be equal to 3. So this 3, this 2 will come in minus. 3 minus 2 is equal to 1. In this way, we can find the value of m. Understood? I'm repeating this again. 2 raised to power m upon 2 raised to power minus 2 is equal to 2 raised to power 3. So this minus 2 will come upper side, is equal to 2 power 3. M and 2, these will be added. M plus 2 equal to 3, base is same, then compare the exponents, m plus 2 is equal to 3, this 2 will come in minus, so value of m is 1. Next example, in this also we have to find the value of m. See the question properly, it was a problem, 5th a, 5th b you can do yourself. See the 5th c, 6 power m into 6 power 3 into 6 power minus 2 divided by 6 power minus 5 is equal to 6 power 12. One thing is clear, base is same everywhere, but we have to put some rules of the exponent. See carefully this one. See, base is same, according to the first rule, base is same, the power will be added. So 6 raised to power m plus 3 plus minus 2, plus minus will become minus here. 6 raised to power m plus 3 minus 2, we know very well, 6 raised to power m plus 3 minus 2 upon, what is upon, 6 raised to power minus 5. Okay, so this minus, when we'll go it upper side, it will become plus. Okay, 6 raised to power m plus 3 minus 2 minus minus 5, getting? See, it was minus na here, upper side will become minus minus 5, this minus minus will become plus. m plus 3 plus 5 minus 2. Solve this. When we will solve this 3 minus 2 plus 5, it will become 6. 3 plus 5, 8. 8 minus 2, 6. So m plus 6, comparing the exponents, m plus 6 is equal to 12. This 6 will come in minus, that side will go. So 6 is equal to 12 minus 6, m is equal to 6. In this way we can get the value of 6. I am repeating this question again. See carefully. There are two ways. See, one is this one. 6 raised to power m, 3 minus 2. This was the question. First exponent rule we have applied. 6 raised to power m plus 3 minus 2 upon this one. 6 raised to power 3 plus minus 2 means 6 minus 3 minus 2 will become 1 here. Right? It will become 1 here. So m plus 1. This minus 5 will come upper side. It will become plus 5. So it will become here directly. You can write one another method. 6 raised to power m plus 6. It will become 6 raised to power 12. Comparing exponents. Here the exponent is m plus 6. Here exponent is 12. So this 6 will get minus on that side. It will become 6. See, this rule is easy. This method is easy. Comparing to that one. See again. M plus 3 minus 2 upon minus 5. Solve it here only. 3 minus 2. 3 minus 2 will be 1. So m plus 1. This minus 5 will come upper side. It will become plus 5. 1 plus 5, 6. 6 raised to power m plus 6 is equal to 6 raised to power 12. Both sides of this equal sign. Base is same. M plus 6 equal to 12. This 6 will get minus. So m is equal to 6. So this is the solution. Got it? Okay. Yes, students. Next problem we are having. Question number 6 of exercise 2.1. See this problem carefully. This kind of question will be there more. By what number should minus 2 upon 3 power minus 3 be divided so that the quotient is 9 upon 8 power minus 2? Means, by which number should I divide this number to get the quotient this? Getting? By which number should I divide this number to get the quotient 9 upon 8 raised to power minus 2? So whenever you will get this kind of questions, always let the number be x, let the number be y, let the number be z. So think of a number, let the number will be x. So what he says, according to the question, by which number should we divide this number to get the quotient this? So this number divided by x will be equal to 9 upon 8 whole power minus 2. Getting? So in this your first work will be keep these values on the same side and the x on the other side of the bracket. Keep the numerical values on this side and this x value on the other side of the bracket. So see what I have done. Minus 2 upon 3 whole power minus 3 is as it is. This 9 upon 8 power minus 2 here, when it will come on this side of the equal to sign, it will become in divided sign. Here it is normal, it will come in division and x will go on that side. Okay, see 9 upon 8 power minus 2, it came on this side and x on the other side of the bracket. Now when the both the numbers are on the same side, then what we'll do, we will change the negative signs into the positive ones. Change their sign. How will change their sign? Doing the reciprocal. Minus 2 upon 3, what it will become? 3 upon minus 2. And 9 upon 8 will become 8 upon 9. See, here the exponents were negative and here the exponents are positive. This thing you keep in your mind. Whenever I want to change the exponents, sign of the exponents, the number will become their reciprocal. Number will become opposite. Minus 2 upon 3 will become 3 upon 2. And this one, minus 2 upon 3 will become 3 upon minus 2. See, this minus can be, we can place anywhere. Minus 3 upon 2, okay. 3 upon minus 2, okay. Or if we put here also, this is also okay. So don't be confused about this. Then divide by 9 upon 8 will become 8 upon 9 power 2 is equal to x. See, now 3 power 3 will become minus 27 and minus the negative of an odd number will become negative always. 3, 3 is a 9, 3 is a 27. Minus sign come here. And cube of 2 will be 8. 2 2s are 4 2s are 8. Okay, I'm expanding this now. 8's here, 8 8s are 64 and 9 9s are 81. Done. This is equal to x. Now see, this is division sign. We can't cut them in the sign of, with the sign of division. We'll have to do the reciprocal. So change this sign of division into the multiplication. This we have done in lower classes, 5, 6, 7. How to convert the division into multiplication? By doing the reciprocal of the next digit. So minus 27 upon 8 will be same. This will become multiplication, and 64 upon 81 will become 81 upon 64. One rule is there. Keep that thing in your mind. Keep, change, flip. Means keep, means keep this number same. Change, change its sign. Multiply to division. Flip means next number will be flipped. Keep, change, flip is equal to x. See now, can we cut any number now? We are not able to cut. 81 not cancelling each other, 64 and 27 are not cancelling each other. So what we'll do? Multiply them. Multiplication done. So minus 2187 and 512. And when we'll take na, it's like prime factorization will do 2187. We'll get 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 7 times. So minus 3 whole raised to power 7. And this 512, when we'll do the prime factorization of this 512, we'll get 2 9 times. 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. It will become 9 times. So its answer is minus 3 raised to power 7 whole divided by 2 raised to power 9. Getting how to do? See a quick revision again. By what number this should be divided to get this one? So what we have done? Bring this number here, x on that side. Negative powers convert into the positive one, then expanded them. 3 3s are 9, 9 3s are 27, 2 cube will become 8 and solve them. And here we'll get the value of the x, that is minus 3 raised to power 7 and 2 raised to power 9. Thank you so much. Now we are having one another problem. 7th question of exercise 2.1. In this question it is given the number 144 is multiplied with 2 raised to power minus 3, 12 power minus 1 and 3 raised to power minus 2 and find the final product. Means this number 144 is consecutively multiplied by 2 raised to power minus 3, then 12 raised to power minus 1, then 3 raised to power minus 2. Multiply all this and find the product. What will be the final product? Let's move towards its solution. So according to the statement, this 144 should be multiplied with 2 raised to power minus 3, 12 raised to power minus 1 and 3 raised to power minus 2. We know very well the rules. 144 means 12 raised to power 2. 12 12s are 144. So 12 raised to power 2 will be 144. This power is a negative sign here. It will come downside positive. 1 upon 2 raised to power 3. 12 power minus 1 means 1 upon 12 power 1. Okay. 3 raised to power minus 2 means 1 upon 3 raised to power 2. Let's solve them. 12 raised to power 2 means 12 into 12. 1 upon 2 power 3 means 2 into 2 into 2. 12 will come as the same. 3 power 2 means 3 into 3. Let's solve them then. See, 12 will cancel with 12. We know very well. 3 1s are 3 and 3 4s are 12. 2 1s are 2. 2 2s are 4. 2 1s are 2. What left upper side? Numerator. Nothing. So 1 upon downside 2 and 3 means 2 into 3 means 1 upon 6, and we know very well 1 upon 6 means 6 raised to power minus 1 is your final product. Understood? So what we are having here, the number 144 should multiply by 2 raised to power minus 3, 12 power minus 1 and 3 power minus 2, find the final product. Okay, according to the statement, multiply this again. 2 raised to power minus 3 means 1 upon 2 raised to power 3, 12 raised 1 upon 12, 1 upon 3 power 2. 2 power 3 means 2 into 2 into 2, 12, and 3 into 3. When we have solved them, it became 1 upon 2 into 3 and 1 upon 6. 1 upon 6 means 6 power minus 1. Understood? Thank you. Yes, students, now we are having the last question. Question number 10 of exercise 2.1. In this question, what we have given, x is equal to 3 upon 2 raised to power 2 into 2 upon 3 raised to power minus 4. If this is the value of x, then find the value of x raised to power minus 2. Not x raised to power 2. They are saying find the value of x raised to power minus 2. So how we'll do this question? We are given the value of x. Firstly, what we'll do? I'm telling the steps. Firstly, what we'll do? We'll find the value of x square. Then we'll do that reciprocal. That will become the value of x raised to power minus 2. Firstly, what we'll do? Firstly, we'll find the value of x square, x raised to power 2. Then we'll do the reciprocal. It will become x raised to power minus 2. See how to solve. We are given x. This value is given to us. Okay? It has a... See, there are two methods to solve this. What is there? 3 upon 2 raised to power 2 means 3 upon 2. 3 upon 2, 2 times. 3 upon 2 raised to power 4. 4 times and 4 times. Solve them. It will become 3 raised to power 6 and 2 raised to power 6. We can simply also do this question. Base same. Add the powers. 3 raised to power 6 upon 2 raised to power 6. 3 upon 2 raised to power 6. This is the value of x. They said find the value of 3 raised, x power minus 2. What we'll do? We got x. I have told you the steps. Firstly, we'll find x. Then we'll find x square. Then we'll do their reciprocal. So we have found here x. Now we'll do the reciprocal. Find the value of x power 2. So x is this. What we'll do if I want the x square? I will do it square 2 times. So what I have done, x square means this is the value of x power 2. Okay, x power 2. We are having one property, one rule. 2 raised to power m into n will become 2 raised to power m multiplied by n. Same is here. This is m, this is n. So 3 upon 2, this power will be multiplied with each other. 6 2s are 12. 6 2s are 12. You can see here 3 upon 2 whole raised to power 12. This is the value of x square. This is the value of x square. What was the first step? Find the value of x. Second step was find the value of x square. We have also found that. Now what we have to do? Find the value of x power minus 2. X square is this much. X power minus 2 will be that reciprocal. See, x power 2 is this much. If I want x raised to power minus 2, so it will also become negative. Yes, na? Or what we can do? We will do the reciprocal. So it will become 2 upon 3 whole raised to power 12. Okay? See this step carefully. Two answers can be there. One, 3 upon 2 whole raised to power minus 12. Why? Because I want a negative. Yes or no? Negative sign I want. So negative sign I have put. Simply. So what it will become? Negative of a number. We know the property. It will become the reciprocal. 2 upon 3 power become plus. Now this is also right. This is also right. Understood? So this was all about our exercise 2.1. All the best.